So how many of you guys have been in this situation before? So you're reading a good book, something about how to be more productive, how to be more wealthy, how to be more handsome, and it's life-changing. You can see the better future right in front of your face. And then here you are, 2 weeks after finishing the book and not remembering a damn thing. Well, it turns out the Italians have a specific phrase for this type of event. I forgot about it. Fortunately for you, there are specific ways to help you remember more of what you read. So in this video, I'll be covering 6 tactics to help you keep those gains in your brains. To keep it simple, I'm gonna be breaking it down into 3 parts: before you read, during you read, and after you read. So let's get right into it. No, not that way. So before you even crack open a spine, it's important for you to ask the question, what am I trying to gain from reading this book? It's the age-old question, what's in it for me? I think it's very important to be intentional about why you're reading in the first place. What's the desired outcome? What are you trying to gain from reading this book? Having these specific questions before you even open it really just help you focus on specific details within the book to map to that desired outcome. And after asking that question, I think it's important to do a little bit of homework before you read the book. You can simply just read book reviews, read summaries. There's tons of great resources on the internet. There's tons of websites out there to help you get a general sense of what the book's even about, to help frame specific ideas and context before you even open the book. And on top of that, before you even dive in, just skim through the table of contents, look through the chapters, and see what the actual book is about to give you an idea, or really just like a framework of some of the ideas that you're about to dive into. All right, so next on this list is during the read. So you open the book, you're reading, you're loving it, you're enjoying it, you're in there. The easiest thing that you can do is read with a pen or a highlighter. The whole goal of this, it's almost like a little treasure hunt. If you find something interesting, something specific to, again, at the beginning of this video, your desired outcome for this book, if you find something that's worth noting, take a pen, underline it, take a highlighter, highlight it, draw a star, whatever you have to do, the whole goal here is to make a notation. So when you're done with the chapter, if you're done with the book, you can easily go back. You're leaving a little breadcrumb trail. You want to go find those nuggets for later. Outside of the obvious of just keeping track of where everything is in terms of the important notes, it's a great way to change your perspective from passive to active. So if you simply have a pen in your hand, you are actually that much more focused on finding something that's interesting, so you can actually use the damn pen. All right, so number 4 in this list, probably the easiest thing that you can do to help you remember more of what you read is simply by limiting your distractions. So I know all of us are attached to the hip with our cell phones, with our laptops, devices, what have you. If you want to remember more of what you're reading, you could simply just put your phone on airplane mode. You can close your laptop. You can shut out all the distractions. You can lock your door so your wife doesn't come in. The whole goal here is to have as much uninterrupted focus as possible. So if you guys are familiar with Cal Newport's deep work, he states that our most impactful work that we have are long stretches of uninterrupted focus. And I think this actually translates very well to when we read and we're trying to learn something new, is that if we're constantly distracted, we got notifications, we've got Slack, we've got emails, we're only going to be very shallow when it comes to what we're learning. But if we can limit those distractions and be as focused as possible when we're reading and trying to learn something new, I think that's going to have a much more lasting effect with this information and hopefully remember it for the long haul. So before we get into the last 2 points, I just want to say thank you for watching this video. If you're enjoying it so far, do me a favor, hit that thumbs up button and subscribe to my channel so you're not missing any future book-related content. All right, back to the last 2. All right, so you're done reading the book. What do you do to help you remember more of what you read? Rather than picking up a new book and jumping into something else, take a minute to read the notes and sit to think. Now, this is an important way to help build more of that knowledge base, the information that you're gathering from the book. So just sit and think about the information. and try to correlate it with other thoughts, other ideas that you currently have. Do you agree with any of this information? Do you disagree? Is this parallel with other things that you've already been thinking about? One of the best things that you can do is take the notes, things that you've been gathering from the book that you've been reading, and try to pull other third-party sources to correlate this information together. So whether that means other books, things that are helping you to build a solid knowledge base, I think this is a great way to help reinforce that information that you're recently learning to help understand it that much better. Another thing that you can do with those notes that you recently took from the book is you can centralize them or organize them in one spot. What I like to do is I like to put them down into note cards so I can review them based off of certain ideas or categorize them based off of the book. I know a lot of people like to put them in notebooks as well, but there's also a lot of great apps out there from free version like the iOS Notes app to other more advanced note-taking apps like Notion or Simple Note. And I think the main goal here is to make sure that those notes, the information that you're gathering, it's just easy to access in the future. So if you want to get back to that, if you want to reference an idea or a note that you took in a book, you want to make sure that you can get to that as easy as possible. And the last thing on this list to help you remember more of what you read is simply by applying what you learn. And there's a couple ways that you can actually do this. Number one is by taking one specific takeaway and try to apply it to your life as quickly as possible. So if there's one specific takeaway that you can implement at work or with your relationships, simply by doing it will help reinforce it that much deeper into your short-term and hopefully long-term memory. Another technique that you can do is use the Feynman technique. This is something that's pretty popular on the internet right now when it was based off of Richard Feynman's technique for learning something new, but take the concept, ideally something that you just learned from the book, and think of it in a way where you would explain it to a young child, basically making it as simple as possible to explain. And while you are doing that, proactively think, are there any gaps in my understanding? While you're explaining it, think to yourself, do I really know what the hell I'm talking about? If there aren't, once you're done, do a little bit more research to fill in those gaps and then repeat the process again. The whole idea is if you can simply explain something in its simplest terms, it will just help reinforce the main concepts, main tenets of that idea, easier for recall, easier for long-term memory. And there we go, those are your six tactics to help you remember more of what you read. So let's recap. Number one, know your why, have an idea of what you want to get out of the book. Number two, do a little preliminary research. Number three, take notes. Number four, focus, help use your environment to create a good environment for learning. Number five, review those notes, organize those notes, and think. Last but not least, make sure you apply or use the Feynman technique. So here's a question for you. What is one simple tip that helps you remember more of what you read? Make sure you comment down below. I will see you down in the comment section. I'll be responding to you. I appreciate everybody who's been commenting on my other videos, and I'll be doing the same. That's all I got for today. Appreciate you watching the video. This is Jim with Get Better With Books signing out. I will see you in the next video. Peace.